So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Now guys, today's session is very very important because today we are going to discuss Swachh Sarvekshan 2021 and mujhe batane ki zarurat nahi padni chahiye that Swachh Sarvekshan 21 mein se definitely one or two question will come in your exam. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed and the link of this group you will find in the description. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question which says, consider the following statements with respect to Swachh Sarvekshan 2021 and you have to identify the correct statements. So question number 2 is also based on this. So let's talk about what is the news. So Swachh Amrit Mahotsav was organized by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. And in this Swachh Amrit Mahotsav, the President of India felicitated the awardees of Swachh Sarvekshan 2021, Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge and Free Star Garbage Free Star Rating for Cities at this Mahotsav, which is known as Swachh Amrit Mahotsav. And of course, this Mahotsav, this event has been organized under the Swachh Bharat Mission Urban Phase 2, jiska Phase 2 abhi chal raha hai, uske under this initiative, this Mahotsav was organized. And during this initiative, these awards were felicitated to the awardees. Now let's talk about the Swachh Sarvekshan 2021 and then we will move ahead to other two categories. So among the cleanest cities in more than 1 lakh population, once again it is Indore, which is at number 1. नंबर 2 सूरत, नंबर 3 विजयवाड़ा. सो इंदौर बहुत ही ज्यादा क्लीन सिटी है बिकॉज काफी सालों से इंदौर जो है नंबर 1 पे अपनी पोजीशन बनाया हुआ है. अमंग द क्लीनेस्ट सिटी इन लेस देन 1 लाख पॉपुलेशन, नंबर 1 इट इज वीटा, नंबर 2 लोनावला, नंबर 3 सासवत एंड ऑल द 3 आर फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेंबर, ऑल द 3 क्लीनेस्ट सिटीज विद लेस देन 1 लाख पॉपुलेशन, टॉप 3 क्लीनेस्ट सिटीज विद लेस देन 1 लाख पॉपुलेशन आर फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र. Varanasi has been declared as the best Ganga town, cleanest cantonment. Ahmedabad is at number 1, Meerut cantonment number 2 and Delhi cantonment number 3. Fastest mover, if I talk about the fastest mover city among those cities which have more than 1 lakh population, Hoshangabad from Madhya Pradesh is at number 1. It has 87th rank in this year's Swachh Sarvekshan, but it had 361st rank in the last year's Swachh Sarvekshan. So it is a, you know, huge jump. ये ह्यूज जंप है 361 से 87 तक. देन फास्टेस्ट मूवर स्टेट मोर देन 100 अर्बन लोकल बॉडीज इट इज कर्नाटका एंड फास्टेस्ट मूवर स्टेट लेस देन 100 लोकल बॉडीज इट इज मिजोरम. टॉकिंग अबाउट मोर अवार्ड, सो क्लीनेस्ट स्टेट अमंग द मोर देन 100 लोकल अर्बन लोकल बॉडीज वंस अगेन इट इज छत्तीसगढ़. क्लीनेस्ट स्टेट लेस देन 100 अर्बन लोकल बॉडीज इट इज झारखंड. मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ अवार्ड्स वर गिवन टू महाराष्ट्र, 92 अवार्ड्स were given to Maharashtra. And under Prerak Daur Samman, which is a new category of awards in the Swachh Sarvekshan 2021, a new category of awards hai. Indore, Surat, Navi Mumbai, New Delhi Municipal Council and Tirupati were categorized as Divya, which is Platinum. And there are 5 category awards under the Prerak Daur Samman, which are of course is not important. You just remember the Divya, the Platinum, the platinum cities which are Indore, Surat, Navi Mumbai, New Delhi Municipal Council and Tirupati. Talking about Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge, so top performance was given by Indore, Navi Mumbai, Nellore and these are the top 4 performers. Top state is Chhattisgarh and top union territory is Chandigarh. Moving ahead to the garbage free star rating, so 9 cities have been awarded the 5 star rating under these ratings, which are Indore, Surat, New Delhi Municipal Council, Navi Mumbai, Ambikapur, Mysuru, Noida, Vijayawada and Patan. Now you should not remember all the names of all the 9 cities. Sari cities ka naam yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Just remember 9 cities have been awarded the 5 star ratings and 143 cities have been awarded the 3 star ratings. Okay. So guys, this was about this news and now let's come back to the question number 1 and 2. Here you have to identify the correct statement. In cities with more than 1 lakh population, Indore has been ranked number 1, absolutely correct. Surat is at number 2. Among the states with more than 100 urban local bodies, Maharashtra topped the ranking. No, that's not Maharashtra, that's Chhattisgarh. And among the UTs, it is Chandigarh. Maximum number of awards were awarded to Gujarat. No, दैट्स महाराष्ट्र, महाराष्ट्र को सबसे ज्यादा मिले हैं। वाराणसी हैज बीन अवॉर्डेड एज द बेस्ट गंगा टाउन, करेक्ट। क्लीनेस्ट कैंटोनमेंट अक्रॉस द कंट्रीज अहमदाबाद कैंटोनमेंट, यस दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट। सो 1, 4, and 5 आर द करेक्ट आंसर, सो ऑप्शन सी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर। एंड लेट मी चेक अबाउट द स्टेटमेंट नंबर 2, अमंग द स्टेट्स विद मोर देन 100 अर्बन लोकल बॉडीज, अमंग द स्टेट विद मोर देन 100 लोकल बॉडी, क्लीनेस्ट स्टेट इज छत्तीसगढ़, यस क्लीनेस्ट स्टेट इज छत्तीसगढ़, नॉट महाराष्ट्र, ओके। सो सेकंड स्टेटमेंट भी इनकरेक्ट है, सो 1, 4, and 5 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन सी। मूविंग राइट टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, हाउ मेनी सिटीज हैव बीन सर्टिफाइड विद 3-star रेटिंग्स अंडर द गार्बेज फ्री रेटिंग्स अवॉर्डेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स हेडेड बाय मिस्टर हरदीप सिंह पुरी। So the 3-star ratings have been awarded to 143 cities, while the 5-star ratings have been awarded to 9 cities. All right. So this, let's move ahead to question number 3 now. By what percent APIDA exports witnessed growth in terms of US dollar during April to October 2021 over the same period of the previous financial year? So APIDA exports has witnessed a huge growth of 14.7%. 14.7%. During the 7 months from April to October 2021 over the same period of previous financial year, that is 2021. Now let's talk about this news. So according to Directorate General of Commercial Intelligence and Statistics, exports of APIDA products witnessed a growth of 14.7% in terms of US dollar during April to October 2021 over the previous financial year. Now remember, exports have been increased from US dollar 10,157 million in last year's financial year to US dollar 11,651 million in this year's financial year. This fact is important for only for the NABARD exam, okay? और बाकी exams में हो सकता है पूछ ले, because आजकल कुछ भी पूछा जा रहा है। Now talking about the individual growth, so in the rice there is a growth of 10.5%. In the category of fresh fruits and vegetable it is 11.6%. Processed food products 29%, other cereals 85.4%, the maximum growth. Meat, dairy and poultry products it is 15.6%, cashew 29.2%, and there is only one product in which there is a negative growth, that is oil meals, and there is a negative growth of 8.9%. Okay. अब ये individual वाले अगर याद हो जाते हैं तो well and good, otherwise there is no need. Just remember the maximum growth is in the other cereals category 85.4%, and there is one product in which there is negative growth, that is 8.9% in the category of oil meals. Okay, so let's come back to the question. So yes, I told you the answer, 14.7% is the correct one. Moving ahead to question number 4, how much percent capital subsidy will be provided for procurement of plant and machinery and service equipments through institutional credit to the SC/ST MSCs under the special capital linked subsidy scheme for service sector? This scheme has been recently launched. This is a newly launched scheme by the Ministry of MSME headed by Mr. Narayan Rane. So let's talk about this scheme. So Ministry of MSME headed by Mr. Narayan Rane has launched Special Capital Link Subsidy Scheme for Service Sector at Guwahati. Also remember ki ye kahan se launch hua hai? Guwahati se. Now this will help in meeting the technology related requirement of enterprises in the service sector. And abhi isme the ministry has not provided any detail. They have just said that the capital subsidy of 25% will be provided for procurement of plant and machinery and service equipment through institutional credit to the SC/ST MSCs. And this capital subsidy will be provided without any sector specific restrictions. कोई भी sector specific restriction नहीं होगा, मतलब service sector में सबको, everyone in the service sector will get this capital subsidy for procurement of plant and machinery and service equipments. All right. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? 25%, option A. 25% guys is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 5, with which Ministry of Panchayati Raj in collaboration with National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj has organized a national conference on the Panchayat Extension to Schedule Areas Act, which in short is PESA 1996. Now remember, this conference was organized to commemorate the 25th anniversary of PESA and as a part of 75th celebration of India's independence. And remember, this ministry guys is Ministry of Tribal Affairs headed by Mr. Arjun Singh Munda. Ministry of Panchayati Raj and Rural Development is headed by Mr. Giriraj Singh. Okay, but let's talk about PESA Act. So remember, PESA Act came into force in 1996 after the recommendation of Bhuria Committee. Bhuria Committee recommended the PESA Act. This act ensures the tribal self-rule for people living in the scheduled areas in the country. And there are 10 countries which have been 10 states which have been identified under the PISA Act where this act should be implemented. Okay. PISA conferred the absolute power to Gram Sabha, where state legislature has only the advisory role. And there are certain powers which have been given to Gram Sabha under the PISA Act, which are right to mandatory consultation in land acquisition, protection of traditional belief, ownership of minor forest products, resolution of local disputes, prevention of land alienation, and exercise of control over money lending. And there are certain more powers which have been given to Gram Sabhas under PISA Act. Okay. So here the correct answer will be what? Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Moving ahead, at which place in Northeast a new Ayurveda college will be established by Ministry of Ayush, which is headed by Mr. Sarbanand Sonowal. Okay, so let's talk about. So remember, Union Minister of Ayush, Sarbanand Sonowal, was attending a session at Northeastern Institutes of Ayurveda and Folk Medicine Research, Northeastern Institute of Ayurveda and Folk Medicine Research at Pasighat. And during this event, four initiatives were launched. Number one, a new Ayurveda college will be established with 30 seats. And this will be established within the campus of this NEIAFMR. A new Ayurveda hospital with 60 beds to be established in the campus of this institute. A total sum of ₹53.72 crores to be invested for the creation of infrastructure within the campus of this institute. And it will definitely create some direct employment for 86 posts to be created to facilitate this initiative. Okay. So, ye itna zyada important isliye hai because a new Ayurveda college will be established at the campus of National Northeastern Institute of Ayurveda and Folk Medicine Research. So here the correct answer will be what, guys? Option D, Pasighat. Pasighat in Arunachal Pradesh, of course. Arunachal Pradesh mein hai, ye yaad rakhenge. Question number 7. Where has FCI's first state-of-the-art laboratory been inaugurated? Kahan pe FCI ka pehla state-of-the-art laboratory inaugurate hua hai? Very direct question. No need to go into the details of this news. It has been inaugurated at Gurugram, which of course in Haryana. Which is kahan pe hai? Which is in Haryana. Alright, so isme zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. It is the first of its kind state-of-the-art laboratory, and this laboratory will be used for the in-house researches of the food grains. In-house research ke liye is laboratory ka use hoga, and it has been inaugurated at Gurugram. And question number 8, which is the last question for today, where has Northeast Education Conclave been organized by Department of Education, Assam, and Shankar Dev Education and Research Foundation? This conclave, guys, was attended by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, who is the Minister of Education. And this conclave was organized at Guwahati, which of course in Assam. So option A is the correct answer. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you tomorrow in the brand new session. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care. And God bless.